Hello, everyone. It's time for Vanished Chicagoland Stories, the podcast. I'm your host, Pico Stanis. This is episode 271, season 11. Today's date is October 31st, 2023. And welcome to the program and happy Halloween, everyone. On today's program, I will talk about my favorite 10 horror movies that aired on Creature Features. That's a program that aired on WGN-TV Channel 9 in Chicago on Saturday nights at 10:30. I'll talk about, you know, my memories of watching that show. And I think that's the only topic I will talk about. So let's get started. Before I do, the program will go to a commercial break. And this program is brought to you by Shasta Orange Soda. I remember this one. And it's a Halloween commercial. So sit back, relax, and look over your shoulder. And be careful. Don't let the monsters get you. And I'll be right back with the program. Thank you, everyone.
Igor, go and get me what I crave.
Evening, Igor.
If you want a better orange soda, made with more natural orange flavor than ever before, try Shasta. It's got the bright color, the sweet smell, and the great taste of oranges. Shasta, it's the orange soda that can make anybody happy.
Okay, everyone, I am back. I hope you enjoyed the commercial for Shasta Orange Soda. That product's still around. I don't find it in Chicago, not really, but it's still available out in California. Let me give you a brief history about that. It was founded in 1889, and their headquarters is in Hayward, California. And the name is from Mount Shasta in Northern California, associated with Shasta Springs. So I remember the flavors they had during the 70s when they advertised. They had cola, grape, orange, ginger ale, root beer. I remember drinking, they had pretty colors, you know, those cans. So in the commercial, the man that's in the store, that's actor John Fielder. He played in a lot of movies and a lot of television. He was the voice of Piglet in the animated TV series Winnie the Pooh. Oh, it's in the movies. I'm sorry. It was movies, that is. And also he was in the 12 Angry Men in that movie. Also, he played Oscar Madison's poker buddies in The Odd Couple. And he was also as Mr. Peterson in the TV series The Bob Newhart Show. So he was a great man. The man who's speaking in the commercial is none other than Tom Bosley, famous for Howard Cunningham in Happy Days. So that's good. He did a lot of announcements. You know, he did announce a lot in the commercials for Shasta. Okay. At the beginning of the program, I said I'm going to do my favorite 10 horror movies that aired on Creature Features on WGN Channel 9 in Chicago. And they aired on Saturday nights at 10:30. Oh, I had great memories. Before I get started, I want to tell you one thing. Went to the doctor yesterday. I had my annual checkup. Everything seemed fine. The funny thing is, when I weighed myself, I gained 5 pounds, but I look so thin, you know. And the doctor knows, no, you lost weight, but don't worry about it. It's your medication. So that's probably what it is. That's bizarre. I don't know. I can't figure it out. He says, don't worry about it. But you look okay. So I might get my results soon, and we'll see what happens. I hope it's good news. All right, so here we go with the countdown. And we'll do it David Letterman style. Okay, so number 10, we have the 1955 movie, Abbott and Costello Meet the Mummy. Oh, I love this movie. has involved with the mummy Claris, and it had involved with a medallion. And I love, there are funny scenes where Lou Costello is like looking in a mirror and he's being tough and he had the tape recorder. Also, when they, him and Abbott went to a restaurant, they order hamburgers and they're switching the medallion, and then Lou Costello's eating it and it landed, you know, it landed in his stomach and they're trying to get the medallion. You know, also when he played he was a snake charmer, and when the snake came out. Okay. All right. So number nine, we have the 1934 movie, The Black Cat, that starred Boris Karloff and Bela Lugosi. That's one of their first movies they starred together. It was very scary. Very scary indeed. And so that was... you know, it's not that memorable by most people, but I loved it. It really is. So, you know, they had a rivalry, you know, together. So, I did that. So it was very scary. Now, there's no monsters in that movie, but it's scary enough. It's suspenseful like that. Okay. Next up, number eight, we have Godzilla. King of the Monsters, that came out in 1954, but then was released in America in 1956, and that starred Raymond Burr as reporter Steve Martin. I remember watching this movie the first time on Creature Features. He's a scary monster, you know, with the fire breathing, destroying Tokyo, like that. And then there were sequels after that. In Japanese, they go Gojira, you know, like that. And they just showed it on Svengoolie about a couple weeks ago. Still a classic. Classic indeed. I love that movie. Okay. Number seven, we have the 1953 movie, Abbott and Costello Meet Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde. It's another horror comedy film where Dr. Jekyll turns into this split personality as Mr. Hyde. He's a monster. And also in the movie, Lou Costello turns into the monster when he's injected with his formula. And he's terrorizing London, scaring all the women and all that. It's scary. It's funny. And towards the end, he bites the London bobbies and the inspector, they all turn into monsters. That was a scary part, you know, as a kid. It's still, I found it a little disturbing for somewhat. And I like when he turned into a mouse and he wanted a piece of cheese. No, it's great like that. Okay. Number six, we have the 1932 movie, The Mummy. Star Boris Karloff as Prince Imhotep, it's a great movie. My favorite scene is when he comes to life, and it's just, oh, with those eyes, it's just, oh, it was like frightening. But I loved the movie, and that was the first mummy movie, and there were sequels and all that, but the first one was the best. I love that movie. I really do. Okay. Right now, I'm going to play the theme song for Creature Features. And that's the song Experiment in Terror, composed by Henry Mancini. They used it in the show. And there's a poem recited by Marty McNeely, who used to do the news on WGN. This is... Everyone remembers that in the beginning of the movie, when the movie's going to begin, they showed that in the introduction. You know, dum, 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 dum. Ugh. Oh, boy. So here it is, the introduction of Creature Features. And then I'll be right back with the rest of the top five. Thank you, everyone.
Vampires.
Okay, everyone, I am back. I hope you enjoyed the introduction of Creature Features with Marty McNeely reciting that famous poem. I would love to see him in the studio recording that. Seemed like a serious man when he did the news, you know, when he did Night Beat and Channel 9 News. And first it was Carl Grayson. I don't know if anyone remembered that. That he did that early on in the show. The show premiered in September 29th, 1970. It's a fan favorite for Chicago fans. It's still scary. They all shared that picture of Lon Chaney Sr. from London After Midnight. Oh, my God. You know, a lot of people have said they want it back. They wanted the program to come back. I don't blame them. Okay. So let's continue. So with the countdown, that is, and number five, we have Frankenstein, the 1931 movie. That's a classic horror movie. And Boris Karloff played the title monster. You know, he's terrorizing everybody and doesn't speak much in the movie. And but the famous line in the movie was... Dr. Frankenstein bringing the creature to life, and he's saying, "It's alive, it's alive, it's alive." Oh, I love that. That's classic. That's so iconic. You know, and when I first watched it on Creature Features, so that scared me. That was scary, you know, but it's a fan favorite among horror fans. Yeah, it really is. Okay, number four, we have the 1941 movie The Wolfman. That was the first, I think it was the first movie that showed a Wolfman. I think there was one in London. I don't know. Was it? I'm not sure. But I remember watching this on Creature Features, and I thought he was the scariest thing on television. And it starred Lon Chaney Jr., and he played the title role. And I felt sorry for him because he was he had this affliction of turning into a wolf when the full moon rose. And he's just, and it was like eerie, Moorish, you know, but it was great, great movie. And I love when Maria I can't say her name, Uspaskanza, that played the gypsy. And she recites, when she recites, when the moon is full, the person will turn into a wolf or something like that. Yeah, I don't remember word from word. You know, they showed that clip in the 1981 movie, The Howling. Yeah, that movie was scary. So, yeah, I love that movie. I really did. And there were sequels. All these movies had sequels after that, which I'll get to in a moment for the next one. And that is number three, The Bride of Frankenstein. And that came out in 1935. And it was the first sequel to Frankenstein. And it was much better than the original one. And that's what most critics and most people say. And the star of the show was Elsa Lancaster. And she played the role of Mary Shelley, the authoress that wrote the novel of Frankenstein. And she played the character at the end of the film. And it was great, you know, to find a bride for Frankenstein because he was lonely. But it's a classic horror movie. That's scary. Oh, that hair and that lightning wig like that. I remember a friend of mine who passed away almost 10 years ago. I went to high school with him. He made fun of one of our principals at Bogan High School. And he said she had hair like that. I'll never forget that. I didn't forget that. It was so funny. Yeah, so that was, like I said, classic horror movie. Okay, number two, we have my all-time favorite horror movie. That's a comedy, is the 1948 movie, Abbott and Costello Meet Frankenstein. That is one of the best. People love this movie, and they still watch it to this day. It's scary, and it's funny, and it features all the monsters. The Wolfman, Dracula, Frankenstein's monster. And towards the end, you have the Invisible Man. Yeah. They said they were going to bring the mummy back, but that didn't happen. So it starred Abbott and Costello, and Bud Abbott was so skeptic about this, about what Lou said. There were so many classic scenes, so many, you know. My favorite is like when they're barricading the door at Dracula's castle, and then the Frankenstein's monster opens it the other side. And, you know, and then Lou Costello's describing each monster, how Frankenstein walks, like that. And then he would describe Dracula, like he put over his coat, over his face, and do the wavy, you know, to hypnotize you. Oh, that's beautiful. I just watched it recently on Svengoolie. It's great. Everything goes. I have it on DVD. Yeah, so it's that is number two. Now here comes number one, and number one is Dracula, the 1931 movie starring Bela Lugosi. That is an all-time classic. It's my all-time favorite horror movie, and it still scares me. You know, when I watch it, it's so atmospheric. It's not really special effects. I mean, when he turns into a bat and turns back and all that, but when he had those eyes that you look at him, and he would hypnotize people, and then he would bite his victims on the neck. But you know, you don't see his fangs. You know, like today's Dracula, they're too toothy. You know, like Fright Night and all that. And but he was the best Dracula. Bar none. He was the best. I loved him, you know. And he only appeared Dracula in a few other movies. I think one for Mark of the Vampire. And the other one was, of course, Abbott and Costello Meet Frankenstein. So, but he did appear in public and did, you know, he did public appearances with that. I think he resented the character at first, but he did portray it on stage before he got hired. And I love that. And you know what's scary about this movie? It's like when he had his brides in the castle, you know, those in the beginning of the movie. Of course, Renfield. You know, in the beginning, he was a very normal-looking guy, you know, staying at Dracula's castle. He didn't know what he was. And then he became a slave, and then he went berserk. Oh, he went crazy. That was actor Dwight Fry. He was great in that. I loved that. He was excellent in the movie. So that is number one of my favorite 10 horror movies that aired on Creature Features on WGN-TV Channel 9. So that's it, folks. And so I'm done for the day, and this podcast will be published later on. It'll be all available where podcasts are, Apple Podcasts, Google Podcasts, Spotify, Amazon Music. Also, it'll be on my blog, vanishedchicagoland.blog. Also on my YouTube channel, Vanished Chicagoland Stories. Please subscribe. People still ask me, where do I find your podcast? You can find it there. Just do a search, hit the subscribe button, take it right there. Also, it'll be posted on my social media accounts, Facebook, X, which is Twitter before, Instagram, Reddit, and also Threads. So you can click on the link, and it'll take you right there. So just be patient. It'll be available. If you have time on Halloween, or you're not going trick-or-treating or having a costume party, you know, and it's cold today, listen in, you know, and just listen to the show. And it's very enjoyable. Okay. So this is Pete Costanos, your host of Van Chicagoland Stories, the podcast. Thank you for joining me. Happy Halloween, everyone. It's chilly outside, and I'll probably do another podcast episode this weekend. And it'll be November. I'm looking forward to it because the holidays are approaching, like Thanksgiving and Christmas. Two of my favorites. Okay, so here's bye-bye for me, and here's a little traveling music saying bye-bye-bye. Take care, everyone, and so long.
We have to go. Bye-bye-bye.